Liji, welcome to your Saheli chat show. Jai Gurudev, Mirana Hegaja Saikon, and with me I've got Gudiel Garcha and Davinda Ubi. Hello ladies, welcome.
Hello, Hello. Jai
Gurudev.
And our Japa topic like I am, Jira, both important, yeah, especially now in the current climate, recycling that. Recycle apa karde hain, properly karde hain, ki nahi karde hege. And recycling there both tarike aa hana ta aaj de samay ch ta both eh jadi paddi ka liya tusi dasso tusi kidda recycle karde karde aa
ke matlab jidda thode jehde plastic samaan hai jidda thode kol bin hunda hai ohde vich tusi rakh sakde jehdi cheez cardboard ya glass ya ta plastic oh main cheezan hundiyan jehdiyan use kar sakde dobara duji gal hai ke je jidda hun tusi ghar de vich hage ha je tusi energy save karni hai tusi sariyan lighta band karo jithe tusi nahi hunde ja heat utho band kar do ohde fir ohde naal fir thode bill vi save hunde ha so ehde naal gaan di gaan एनर्जी गाँव के जिहड़े न्याणे लई आ उन्होंने भी फायदा होना है करके जिनी एनर्जी असी यूज करते हैं इट्स टू मच बहुत ज़्यादा यूज करते हैं जे मतलब तुसी किते जाना आ तुसी किते किसी ने मिल जाना फिर तुसी ट्राई करो भी दो तीन काम उहदे नाल ही हो जाण के फिर थोड़ी जिहड़ा फ्यूल है थोड़ी गड्डी च वह सेव हुंदा आ तां जां शॉपिंग कर ले किसी ने मिल लिया ਹੋਰ ਕਿਸੇ ਦੀ ਸ਼ੋਪਿੰਗ ਨਾਲ ਕਰ ਲਈ ਜਾਂ ਕੁਛ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਫਿਰ ਉਹਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਫਾਇਦਾ ਹੋਣਾ ਹੈ
ਜਿਹੜੀ ਸ਼ੋਪਿੰਗ 'ਤੇ ਗੱਲ ਆ ਜਿੱਦਾਂ ਆਪਾਂ ਖਾਣਾ ਪੀਣਾ ਵੀ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਖਰੀਦਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਫਿਰ ਵੇਸਟੇਜ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਆ ਐਵਰੀ ਵੀਕ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਘਰਾਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਦੋਂ ਆਪਾਂ ਨਵਾਂ ਸਮਾਨ ਲਿਆਉਂਦੇ ਫਰਿੱਜਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਕਿੰਨਾ ਕੁਛ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਜਿਹਦੀ ਡੇਟ ਲੰਘੀ ਆ ਜਾਂ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਅਸੀਂ ਯੂਜ਼ ਨਹੀਂ ਕੀਤਾ ਹੈਗਾ ਸੋ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਖਰੀਦੋ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਜਿੰਨਾ ਆਪਾਂ ਯੂਜ਼ ਕਰ ਸਕੀਏ ਐਂਡ ਉਹੀ ਅਸਰ ਹੋਊਗਾ ਆਪਣੇ ਯੰਗ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ 'ਤੇ ਹੈ ਨਾ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਜੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਫਰਿੱਜ ਭਰ ਕੇ ਰੱਖਦੇ ਭਾਵੇਂ ਕੋਈ ਖਾਂਦਾ ਭਾਵੇਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਗਾਂਹ ਵਾਲਾ ਜਨਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਵੀ ਦੇਖਦੇ ਆ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਵੀ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਹੀ ਕਰਨਾ ਆ ਰਾਈਟ ਸੋ ਦੈਟਸ ਇੰਪੋਰਟੈਂਟ ਐਕਸ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਹੋਰ ਕਿਹਾ ਜੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਗੱਡੀ 'ਚ ਨਿਕਲੇ ਆ ਦੋ ਤਿੰਨ ਚੀਜ਼ਾਂ ਇਕੱਠੀਆਂ ਕਰਕੇ ਆਓ ਚਾਹੇ ਜੇ ਗੱਡੀ ਦੀ ਜ਼ਰੂਰੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈਗੀ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਤੁਰ ਕੇ ਜਾ ਸਕਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਉਹ ਵੀ ਤੁਰ ਕੇ ਜਾਵੋ ਬਿਕਾਜ਼ ਦੈਟ ਇਜ਼ ਸੋ ਇੰਪੋਰਟੈਂਟ ਐਂਡ ਪਲਾਨ ਯੋ ਜਿੱਦਾਂ ਆਪਾਂ ਖਾਣਾ ਪੀਣਾ ਲਿਆਉਂਦੇ ਮੀਲਸ ਪਲਾਨ ਕਰੋ ਤਾਂ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਘੱਟ ਖਰੀਦੋਗੇ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਕੋਲ ਪਲਾਨ ਹੋਊਗਾ ਰਾਈਟ
ਤਾਂ ਨਾਲੇ ਕਈਆਂ ਦੇ ਕੋਲ ਵੱਡੇ ਫਰੀਜ਼ਰ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਆ ਪਿੱਛੇ ਰੱਖੇ ਤਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ 'ਚੋਂ ਜਿੱਦਾਂ ਵਿਹਲੇ ਕਵੇਲੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਸਮਾਨ ਉਹ ਕੱਢਦੇ ਪਰ ਉਹਦਾ ਵੀ ਫਿਰ ਬਿਜਲੀ ਦਾ ਬਿੱਲ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੁਣ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਆ ਇਲੈਕਟ੍ਰੀਸਿਟੀ ਗੈਸ ਸਾਰਾ ਕੁਛ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਹੋ ਜਾਣਾ ਆ ਆਹ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਮੋਰਲੇ ਮਹੀਨੇ ਆਉਣੇ ਆ ਸੋ ਜੇ ਉਹ ਸਮਾਨ ਜ਼ਰੂਰੀ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਲਈ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈਗਾ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਉਹ ਫਿਨਿਸ਼ ਕਰਕੇ ਫਰੀਜ਼ਰ ਉਹ ਬੰਦ ਕਰ ਦਿਉ ਅਤੇ ਨਾਲ ਦੀ ਨਾਲ ਜਿੱਦਾਂ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਖਾਣਾ ਹੈਗਾ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਪਲਾਨ ਕਰੋ ਤਾਂ ਹਿਸਾਬ ਨਾਲ ਫਿਰ ਲਿਆਇਆ ਕਰੋ ਫਿਰ ਤੁਹਾਡੀ ਵੇਸਟੇਜ ਵੀ ਘੱਟ ਹੋਣੀ ਆ ਫਿਰ ਉਹ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਲੈਂਡਫਿਲ ਆ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਉਹ ਧਰਤੀ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੱਡੀਆਂ ਸਾਰੀਆਂ ਗਲੀਆਂ ਬਣਾਉਂਦੇ ਆ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਸੈੱਟ ਸਕਦੇ ਆ ਉਹ ਫਿਰ ਘੱਟ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਆ ਸੋ ਸਾਡੇ ਇਕੱਲੇ ਇਕੱਲੇ ਨੇ ਅਸਰ ਜੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਜਿਹਾ ਮਾਈਂਡਫੁਲ ਹੋਈਏ ਵੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਚੀਜ਼ ਅਸੀਂ ਲਿਆਉਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਖਰੀਦਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਜਾਂ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਯੂਜ਼ ਹੋਣੀ ਚਾਹੀਦੀ ਆ ਘੱਟ ਤੋਂ ਘੱਟ
This I is think it. And do your bit for the environment. Yeah. ਇਹੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਮੈਸੇਜ ਪਾਸ ਕਰਦੇ ਵੀ ਸਾਰੇ ਜਣੇ ਜੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਕਰੀਏ ਇਨਵਾਇਰਮੈਂਟ ਲਈ ਤਾਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਵੱਲੋਂ ਆਪਾਂ ਸਹੀ ਰੀਸਾਈਕਲਿੰਗ ਕਰੀਏ ਕਿੰਨਾ ਫਰਕ ਪੈ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਆ
ਨਾਲੇ ਸਾਡੇ ਲਈ ਫਾਇਦਾ
ਹੈ ਹਾਂਜੀ
ਯੈਸ ਅੰਡਕ ਮੇਰੀ ਆਦਤ ਹੈ ਬਹੁਤ ਕੁਝ ਬਣਾਉਣੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਬਣਾ ਲੈਂਦੀ ਹਾਂ ਐਂਡ ਮੈਂ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕਰਦੀ ਹਾਂ ਪਰ ਹਮੇਸ਼ਾ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਬਣ ਨਹੀਂ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਸੋ ਆਈ ਡੋਂਟ ਲਾਈਕ ਵੇਸਟਿੰਗ ਇਟ ਹੈ ਨਾ ਆਈ ਵੁੱਡ ਲਾਈਕ ਟੂ ਲਾਈਕ ਸੇ ਨਿਆਣੇ ਹਨ ਬੱਚੇ ਉਹ ਕਹਿੰਦਾ ਉਹ ਫੂਡ ਲਾਈਕ ਦੀ ਅਦਰ ਡੇ ਮੈਂ ਆਲੂ ਗੋਭੀ ਬਣਾਈ ਸੀਗੀ ਕਹਿੰਦਾ ਦੂਜੇ ਦਿਨ ਨਹੀਂ ਖਾਣੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਸੋ ਆਈ ਥਿੰਕ ਇਟ ਵਾਸ ਫਾਈਨ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਡੋਂਟ ਫੋਰਸ ਦਮ ਹੈ ਨਾ ਫਿਰ ਮੈਂ ਫਰੀਜ਼ ਕਰ ਲੈਂਦੀ ਹਾਂ
ਜਾਂ ਮੇਕ ਇਟ ਹਾਂ ਜਾਂ ਸ਼ੇਅਰ ਕਰ ਲਓ ਕਿਸੇ ਨਾਲ ਜੇ ਤੁਹਾਡੀ ਕੋਲ ਫੈਮਿਲੀ ਹੈਗੀ ਆ ਜੇ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਕੋਲ ਬਣ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਜਿੱਦਾਂ ਮਾਹਾਂ ਦੀ ਦਾਲ ਜਿੱਦਾਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਘੰਟੇ ਲੱਗਦੇ ਬਣਾਉਣ ਨੂੰ ਜਾਂ ਸਾਗ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਸ਼ੇਅਰ ਕਰ ਲੈਂਦੇ ਉਹਦਾ ਵੀ ਬਹੁਤ ਫਾਇਦਾ ਆ
ਡੈਫੀਨਟਲੀ ਤਾਂ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਇੱਕ ਹੋਰ ਗੱਲ ਆ ਚਲ ਖਾਣਾ ਪੀਣਾ ਆਪਾਂ ਕਵਰ ਕੀਤਾ ਤਾਂ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਕੱਪੜੇ ਲੀੜੇ ਆ ਹੁਣ ਦੇਖੋ ਯੰਗ ਨਿਆਣੇ ਕਿੰਨੇ ਕੱਪੜੇ ਕਿੰਨੇ ਸ਼ੂ ਖਰੀਦਦੇ ਆ ਅਮੀ ਮੈਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਘਰ ਦਾ ਐਗਜ਼ਾਮਪਲ ਦਵਾਂ ਮੇਰੀ ਛੋਟੀ ਕੁੜੀ ਇਸ ਬਹੁਤ ਕੁਛ ਖਰੀਦਦੀ ਆ ਰਾਈਟ ਸੋ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਨਿਆਣੇ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਖਰੀਦਦੇ ਆ ਐਂਡ ਹੁਣ ਸੈਕਿੰਡ ਹੈਂਡ ਫੈਸ਼ਨ ਇਟਸ ਨੋਟ ਅ ਬੈਡ ਥਿੰਗ ਸਪੈਸ਼ਲੀ ਆਪਣੇ ਇੰਡੀਅਨ ਕੱਪੜਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਬ੍ਰਾਈਟ ਕਲਰਸ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਪੈਸੇ ਵੀ ਬਹੁਤ ਲੱਗੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਕੱਪੜਿਆਂ 'ਤੇ ਤਾਂ ਆਪਾਂ ਮੁੜ ਕੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਉਹ ਸੂਟ ਪਾਉਣਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਵੀ ਮੈਂ ਅੱਗੇ ਪਾ ਲਿਆ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਉਹ ਨਿਗਾਹ ਵਿੱਚ ਆ ਪਛਾਣ ਲੈਣਾ ਮੈਂ ਹੁਣ ਉਹ ਨਹੀਂ ਪਾਉਣਾ ਹੁਣ ਮੈਂ ਦੇਖਿਆ
ਕਿਉਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਪਾਉਣਾ ਦੱਸ ਤੇ
ਕਿਉਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਪਾਉਣਾ ਬਿਕਾਜ਼ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਨੇ ਦੇਖਿਆ ਆ ਤਾਂ ਬ੍ਰਾਈਟ ਕਲਰਸ ਆ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਯਾਦ ਆ
ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਨੇ ਦੇਖਿਆ
So this is why we should either share, borrow each other's kapde,
or
we should sell them. Ekbari pale, see if you can give them to charity or sell them on. Because tuhade ghar toh uddi pehre ne 3-4 saal je tusi na paya, at least je tusi bechta, hon, there's a couple of ladies. ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਕੀਤਾ ਆ ਆਈ ਥਿੰਕ ਇਟਸ ਬ੍ਰਿਲੀਅੰਟ
ਆਈ ਥਿੰਕ ਇਟਸ
ਬਿਕਾਜ਼ ਆ ਸੂਟ ਸਾਰ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਘੜੀ 10 20 ਐਕਸਟਰਾ ਪਏ ਹੋਣੇ ਆ ਐਂ ਜੇ ਆਪਾਂ
ਬੈਠ ਕੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਰੱਖੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ
ਆ ਉਹ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਚੀਜ਼ ਅਟਕ ਚ ਚਲ ਗਈ ਉਹ ਨਿਕਲਣੀ ਆ ਮੁੜ ਕੇ ਵੇ ਹੋਲਡਿੰਗ ਰਾਈਟ
ਦੈਟਸ ਰਾਈਟ
ਤਾਂ ਸੋ ਵੀ ਨੀਡ ਟੂ ਮੇਕ ਅ ਚੇਂਜ ਐਂਡ ਹੈਗਾ ਸੀ ਅੱਗੇ ਸਟਿਗਮਾ ਆਪਣੇ ਲੋਕ ਸੈਕਿੰਡ ਹੈਂਡ ਸ਼ਾਪਾਂ ਚੋਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਖਰੀਦਦੇ ਸੀਗੇ ਹਨਾ ਪਰ ਆਈ ਥਿੰਕ ਉਹ ਵੀ ਕਰਕੇ ਸੈਕਿੰਡ ਹੈਂਡ ਸ਼ਾਪਾਂ 'ਚ ਵੀ ਕੱਪੜੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਵਧੀਆ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਅੱਜ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਡਿਜ਼ਾਈਨਰ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਕਿਸੇ ਨੇ ਇੱਕ ਅੱਧੀ ਵਾਰੀ ਪਾਇਆ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਤਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਦੇ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਹਨਾ
ਆਪਣੇ ਖਿਆਲਾਂ 'ਤੇ ਡਿਪੈਂਡ ਕਰਦਾ ਹੈ ਸੈਕਿੰਡ ਹੈਂਡ ਕਿਉਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਚੀਜ਼ ਲੈਣੀ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਇਟ ਮੇਕਸ ਯੂ ਫੀਲ ਅਸੀਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਗਰੀਬ ਹਾਂ ਕਿ ਆਪਣਾ ਗਰੀਬ ਨਹੀਂ ਸਮਝਣਾ ਆਪਣਾ ਹੁਣ ਅਸੀਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਅਮੀਰ ਹਾਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਪੈਸੇ ਵਾਲੇ ਹਾਂ
ਯੂ
ਨੋ ਅਸੀਂ ਉਹ ਬੈਗਰ ਵਾਂਗਰ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈਗੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਸੈਕਿੰਡ ਹੈਂਡ ਸ਼ੋਪ 'ਤੇ ਜਾਣਾ ਇਟਸ ਜਸਟ ਆਪਣੀ ਮੈਂਟੈਲਿਟੀ
ਯਾ ਉਦਾਂ ਆਪਾਂ ਇੱਥੇ ਰਹਿੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਆਪਾਂ ਬ੍ਰਿਟਿਸ਼ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਨੂੰ ਦੈਟਸ ਅ ਬਿਗ ਬ੍ਰਿਟਿਸ਼ ਥਿੰਗ ਨਾਲੇ ਜੰਬੋ ਸੈਲਸ ਲਾਉਂਦੇ ਬ੍ਰਿਟਿਸ਼ ਲੋਕ ਰਾਈਟ ਦੈਵ ਆਲਵੇਸ ਡਨ ਦਮ ਵਨ ਵੀ ਵਰ ਗਰੋਇੰਗ ਅਪ ਦੈਵ ਵਰ ਜੰਬੋ ਸੈਲਸ ਐਂਡ ਸੋ ਇਟਸ ਜਸਟ ਰੀਲੀ ਕਲੋਥਿੰਗ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਬਿਗ ਥਿੰਗ ਐਂਡ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਜੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਪਾਉਣੇ ਜੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਚੈਰਿਟੀ ਨੂੰ ਨਹੀਂ ਦੇਣੇ ਕਿਸੇ ਨੂੰ ਦੇ ਦਿਓ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਉਹ ਕਿਸੇ ਦੇ ਕੰਮ ਆਓਗੇ ਮੈਂ ਤਾਂ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਕਰਦੀ ਹਾਂ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਓਨੈਸਟ ਐਵਰੀ ਸੋ ਆਫਨ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਲੀਅਰ ਆਊਟ ਕਰਕੇ ਤਾਂ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਕੱਪੜੇ ਲੀੜੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਪਾਉਣੇ ਮੈਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਕੰਮ 'ਤੇ ਕੋਲੀਗਸ ਨੂੰ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਦੇ ਦਿੰਦੀ ਹਾਂ ਜਾਂ ਫਰੈਂਡਸ ਨੂੰ ਦੇ ਦਿੰਦੀ ਹਾਂ ਬਈ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਡੋਂਟ ਮਾਈਂਡ ਮੋਸਟ ਪੀਪਲ ਡੋਂਟ ਮਾਈਂਡ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਕੱਪੜੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਕਿਹੜੇ ਖਰਾਬ ਹੋਏ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਆ ਸੋ ਆਈ ਥਿੰਕ ਦੈਟਸ ਅ ਰੀਅਲੀ ਬਿਗ ਵਨ
ਜਦੋਂ ਲੋਕਡਾਊਨ ਸੀ ਨਾ ਉਦੋਂ ਓਬਵੀਅਸਲੀ ਟਾਈਮ ਸੀਗਾ ਐਂਡ ਓਬਵੀਅਸਲੀ ਘਰ ਦੀ ਡੈਕੋਰੇਟਿੰਗ ਵੀ ਸੀ ਕਰਦੇ ਸੀਗੇ ਐਂਡ ਆਈ ਟੈਲ ਯੂ ਮੈਂ ਆਈ ਥਿੰਕ ਦੈਟ I think 8-10 kale bag assi pare with kapde
and I think saryan nu apni almariyan vich dekho ta just to a little list just think aa main paya 6 mahine ho gaye saal hoya paya nahi aa mere khulla aya peera aya tusi theek karana ya ki nahi karana je tusi nahi karana kuch vi onu the chances are utthe peya rehna oh kapda so get rid of it
and aaj kal shopping online bahut easy hai so okay let's see kapde khali vi kar liye but the online shopping it becomes such a craze now hai na fashion ho gaya oh fatafat oh lamari phir bhi par gayi
yes
so we got a habit of keep buying things because easier
we haven't we all like a bargain apa jande nahi vich aida hunda we end up buying it but generation z like I said 9 to 24 year olds are the worst
yeah
unna de kapde sab to jyada unna de hunde aa
it's like that in my house my son's got so many but you know at the moment I always think I'm blessed that we have enough to spend as well but then there has to be a line when you know, you don't like them okay cupboard the finding the cupboard when they start outside on the floor and in the other parts of the house then you start thinking this is getting too much or the thora jay you have to be a bit sensible around it hana
technology to see oh cheez 3-4 mahine 6 mahine saal ho gaye thonu paye nu ਤਾਂ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਲੱਗਦਾ ਵੀ ਮੁੜ ਕੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਪਾਉਣੀ ਕਈ ਵਾਰੀ ਸਾਡੇ ਤੋਂ ਛੱਡ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਉਹ ਚੀਜ਼ ਕਰਕੇ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਵੀਵ ਗਾਟ ਸਮ ਇਮੋਸ਼ਨਲ ਅਟੈਚਮੈਂਟ ਟੂ ਦੈਟ
ਬਟ ਦੈਟਸ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਬੈਕ 20 30 ਸਾਲ ਵੀ ਚੀਜ਼ ਕੱਪੜੇ
ਕੋਈ ਕੋਈ ਸਾੜੀਆਂ ਹੁੰਦੀਆਂ ਹੈ ਕਹਿਣਾ ਵੀ ਪਤਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਮੁੜ ਕੇ ਕਦੋਂ ਪਾਉਗੀ ਸ਼ਾਇਦ ਪਾਉ ਜੀ ਮੈਂ ਰੱਖ ਲੈਨੇ ਆ ਹਨਾ
ਬਟ ਬੀ ਆਨਸਟ
ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਟੂ ਗੈਟ ਰਿਡ
ਬਟ ਆਈ ਹੈਵ ਮਾਈ ਵੈਡਿੰਗ ਦੇ ਕੱਪੜੇ ਆਈ ਸਟਿਲ ਹੈਵ ਮਾਈ ਦਾਜ ਐਂਡ ਬਰੀ ਦੇ ਕੱਪੜੇ ਦੋਸ ਆਰ ਸਟਿਲ ਕੈਟ ਬਿਕਾਜ਼ ਆਈ ਡੂ ਵੇਅਰ ਥਮ
ਆ ਸੋ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਵੇਅਰ ਥਮ ਦੈਨ ਇਟਸ ਗੁੱਡ
ਆਈ ਡੂ ਵੇਅਰ ਥਮ ਐਂਡ ਦੇ ਫੀਲ ਨਾਈਸਰ ਟੂ ਵੇਅਰ ਥਮ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਦੇ ਲਾਈਕ ਹੀ ਸੈਡ ਬਟ I still I find that's my I like to I've still kept on to those and
so hopefully this is just giving people like you know just a little refresher course like or food for thought thinking yes you know it's important and we never look at this and there are things that we can all do you know for the environment when we do our little bit
but so, there's something around the hoarding bit you know on a, like you said on the mindset is because there's a I don't know a belief in that of scarcity of lack so there's a fear of don't have enough so we don't realize on an unconscious subconscious level we end up hoarding fear of not having enough in the future even though we have enough sare in cupboards sare pare paya but still that program I don't have enough that we have this you know it's like a disease of hoarding and hoarding and hoarding
and god forbid a friend of mine was telling me how much her sister used to buy right all the time and sadly she passed away she was it was so hard for us to sort out all her stuff because it emotionally is upsetting and then they look like oh my god you know she used to say she hasn't got money for xyz but the cast man kinara kya
yeah
just little things like that it makes you think right
yeah
and I think as we get older I mean I can speak about my own experience with my mom you know emptying her flat out luckily she didn't have too much stuff but when you've got a whole house full of stuff imagine you know somebody's got to clear that out
yeah this
so
is
a good idea as we get older to to start letting go of stuff that we know we're never going to use again, and and it's actually, it's good for us to do that.
Definitely.
And for the person that's, you know, we're all going to go one day, and it's important that we kind of do this ourselves and rather than relying on somebody else to do it.
And this is what we do really with Your Saheli. We talk about all things that people don't talk about or forget about or like to forget about. Let's, you know, talk about these things, right? Because they do affect all of us. And I mean, at the moment, like you touched on this, Gadia, like electric, gas, their bill, eightfolds they're going to go up by. How are we going to cope with that? So Japan, we're going to struggle. Everybody's going to struggle. And the cost of living, it's, you know, going up. Our salaries aren't going up like that. So there is a lot to think about.
And because most of these bills are going in direct debit, it's only this thing you pay. But then like that. So I'm all, if I go upstairs and I see the light switched on and everybody's sitting downstairs, I always say, why have you left your light on when you decided to need your bed here? It's just they don't realise, you know, we don't realise that money is actually, we're losing it bit, you know, minute by minute.
Nyane phone charging till on there, right? And then they pull the phone out. They don't even switch the charger, that button off, right? They don't switch it off to say, it's charged, but I need to take my phone, but I need to switch it off.
There's just little things that we can all do, like, you know, make sure your washing machine's full and not just do half loads, and don't leave the water running when you're brushing your teeth. Don't have heating on when you're not at home, because you can get these smart switches now where you can just, you know, put the heating on an hour before you go home, so that, you know, you're saving so much energy, and it is worth investing £150 on that, so that, you know, you're only having mindful. The heating on, not all the time.
I think try a month on it. 2 months,
definitely.
A new lifestyle change, new habits, and notice how much money we're saving.
Exactly.
Different spender.
Keep having these conversations, because when you keep having the conversations, the change happens. And with everything going up, like we said, you know, it's time to take stock of your household bills, expenses, etc., and keep an eye on those direct debits. You need to have a look to see what's going out, because energy company and your banking company, they're all very clever. Said a direct debit, said toyaya. A lot of people don't even look.
And
what
the other
we
thing
need to
is,
be mindful.
If you change kar sakde thoda direct debit to a different company, every year you change kar sakde jithe thode paise kat lagne ha. So, je thonu aap nahi pata, then you can get help from somebody. I mean, I'm lucky. My son will constantly, you know, every year he will go through, you know, the electricity, gas, and go over to a different company. And some people don't realise that. They'll just stick with the same company. And they may be charging bahut jyada paise lende hoge thode ton. So, you know, it's good to speak to somebody and get some kind of help.
Brilliant, thank you. So that was the bit that we covered on the recycling bit. Now we're going to go on to a little bit about, I'm going to come to Dav about energy, our energy, apni energy.
Hanji.
And jidda pagal ka desige, jidda koi bhi gal hundi ya, jithe banda hunda ya, unhe utho hi bolna hai, na koi right hai, na koi wrong hai, jo koi question puchhiye about energy levels, ja kise de naal thodi energy mildi ya, nahi mildi, or whether you're you know, emotionally stressed or drained or fatigue, how it can impact, you know, how we can look after our energy.
So we can talk, we can go into that, and we can say how it works from the house as well. Do the energy even around the house, everything. Look ale toale kidane thode pictures, you know, did bug clara kinna pya, and you know that all impacts our thinking and sadi soch. Even I see people with beds manje de niche kinna rubbish smal rakhya
hunda, energy has to flow, right?
Energy is not flowing properly, so it has an impact sadi soch there.
Kake to sikende, I feel so stressed, I feel so anxious, and I feel so fatigued. Does it matter if you have a little bit of a sara clay area? You know, you might have a big kitchen, but sara kunje pade hoge kasana, or underneath the tables be saman hoga. The energy isn't flowing. And this is where Dav comes in, because she's such a spiritual, like mindfulness coach, and I love chatting with her. So I thought, let's have her expertise on this, right? Because energy is everything, and it's everywhere. We're born out of energy, and you can change that.
Absolutely, Hanjita. I know some families and friends that ਸਮਾਨ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਦੇ ਘਰ ਰੱਖਿਆ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਦੈਟ ਇਟ ਹੈਜ਼ ਅ ਲੋਟ ਆਫ ਮੈਮਰੀਜ਼ ਟੂ ਇਟ ਲਾਈਕ ਸੈਡ ਮੈਮਰੀਜ਼ ਆਫ ਸਮਬਡੀ ਦੈਟ ਮੇ ਬੀ ਹੈਡ ਪਾਸਡ ਔਨ ਔਰ ਸਮਬਡੀ ਦੈਟ ਯੂਸ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਕਲੋਸ ਐਂਡ ਸੈਪਰੇਟਡ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਕੁਡ ਹੈਵ ਬੀਨ ਅ ਡਿਵੋਰਸ ਔਰ ਸਮਥਿੰਗ ਬਟ ਇਫ ਦੇ ਸਟਿਲ ਹੋਲਡ ਔਨ ਟੂ ਦੋਜ਼ ਲਾਈਕ ਦੋਜ਼ ਈਵਨ ਦੇ ਕਲੋਜ਼ ਔਰ ਪਿਕਚਰਸ ਔਰ ਸਮਥਿੰਗ ਇਟ ਹੋਲਡਸ ਦੀਜ਼ ਮੈਮਰੀਜ਼ ਦੈਟ ਬ੍ਰਿੰਗ ਔਨ ਫੀਲਿੰਗ ਆਫ ਸਟ੍ਰੈਸ ਐਂਡ ਐਂਗਜ਼ਾਇਟੀ ਵਿਦ ਇਨ ਦਮਸੈਲਵਸ ਸੋ ਦੋਜ਼ ਥਿੰਗਸ ਅਰਾਊਂਡ ਦਾ ਹਾਊਸ ਡਸ ਹੈਵ ਐਨ ਇੰਪੈਕਟ ਔਨ ਦੈਟ ਪਰਸਨਸ ਥਿੰਕਿੰਗ ਐਂਡ ਫਿਊਚਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਹੀ ਫਿਰ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਉਹੀ ਪ੍ਰੋਬਲਮਸ ਆਈ ਜਾਣਗੇ ਉਹੀ ਕਾਈਂਡ ਆਫ ਰਿਲੇਸ਼ਨਸ਼ਿਪਸ ਵਿਲ ਕੀਪ ਅਟਰੈਕਟਿੰਗ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਦੀ ਐਨਰਜੀ ਸਟਿਲ ਦੇਅਰ ਇਨ ਦਾ ਹਾਊਸ ਐਂਡ ਇਟ ਸਟਿਲ ਕੀਪ ਫਲੋਇੰਗ ਇਨ ਐਂਡ ਥਰੂ ਦੈਮ ਆਲ ਦਾ ਟਾਈਮ ਸੋ ਇਟਸ ਇੰਪੋਰਟੈਂਟ ਦੈਟ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਅ ਮੈਮਰੀ ਇਜ਼ ਸਮਥਿੰਗ ਇਨ ਦਾ ਹਾਊਸ ਇਟ ਕੁਡ ਬੀ ਲਾਈਕ ਯੂ ਸੇ ਪਿਕਚਰ ਐਨੀਥਿੰਗ ਐਂਡ ਇਟ ਬ੍ਰਿੰਗਸ you know it triggers off a lot of sadness negative and hurt
yeah.
you know either change the picture in it take it somewhere else it sara impact panda on our thinking how we attract
definitely
you know so same sort of scenarios and situations yeah. in our life so just look at your house and think that what part of your house you don't feel like walking into you don't feel comfortable in and change it change the setting the color the smell that all has an impact on our energy
Yeah, this is like a situation, you know, say you walk into a house.
Yeah.
Energy, ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਪਤਾ ਲੱਗ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਕਿੱਦਾਂ ਦੀ ਹੈ, ਇਸ ਘਰ ਦੀ, doesn't it?
That's right.
And, you know, you might really like it, you might not like it.
Yes.
So.
I mean, I'm just thinking about somebody very close to me who's, unfortunately, one of their children passed away. And their bedroom is almost like a shrine.
Yeah.
So, I understand what you're saying in terms of, you know if it's a picture that creates all those sad feelings and memory of loss and but at the same time that could be a place of peace and remembrance
and
positivity of having nice pictures of that person and remembering the good times and
we
and
do
helping us to uplift you know rather than to make us feel negative
exactly.
so yeah that's really really important
so if it brings peace then those are things that you hold on to and keep with lots of love and respect but if it reminds you and triggers you of something bad and sadness and hurt then those your responsibility remove them because sometimes another from the family wants to keep them and you find that it brings a lot of pain and hurt to you then you know you got to be brave enough to do what brings yours you know sense of peace and harmony within yourself
and we all have these tools right it's just knowing how to use them and to your benefit and it's like for us in our house like my husband passed away nearly 14 years ago we have pictures of him in all the rooms but they're all happy pictures and it's how we remember him it's you know so they don't get back they don't say oh my god it feels really sad house because you don't want that because you're going to walk into there every day your children are going to be there all the time so it's up to you how you're going to make that place you know the best possible and give it the good vibes that you want so your energy is everything again we are responsible for it so although we care can I draw
another thing got to be like I said be careful about so when I do buy something from let's say like a jumbo sale or something that some it belonged to someone else so when I bring that to the my house I know it's going to carry the energy of the environment it was in I don't know what kind of environment that was so when I bring that home I always cleanse it I either do just pray or do part or just put love and energy into it you know so I'll try and you know put my energy into it
but
energy of like love and peace and
lovely that is and you know apakar agarbatti laundi am right so that creates a nice energy doesn't it in all the rooms you go around and you put the agarbatti on and you know you do your part and it just feels so nice and you then you start to get all the things that you're grateful for coming up and you know gratitude and it grows and you get more of it and I'm a big one for that because I think often jadon apne ko 10 sukh hunde hai ek you know sukh chala gaya we concentrate on that one dukh that we've got right and we forget the 9 sukh that god babaji's given us
that's right
on as the focus karo and remember them and you'll get more of that
Absolutely.
Because life is a journey and you know we will lose loved ones as hard as it is there's nothing we can do and apne sathe guru ji ne apanu dekho kinna strong religion ditta kinna faith ya ode vich kinna shakti ya to accept karke hukm ya paana ya manna penda ya te je apan nahi vi mande dekha baba ji nu manana vi aunda ya
oh yes
you know
definitely.
You have to
kush kar sahi path te leke aunde aunde so
jo bhi hunda ya ode koi reason hundi hai kehde apan nu nahi pata lagda changa nahi lagda and I understand cuz we've been through it and so many other people are suffering but you know you have to just expect that the next stage is going to be better. The next days, years live coming are going to be better. So live in hope and be grateful for what we've got. Yeah. We must never forget. That's a big one.
Should we discuss about when we barney vegera and the food we eat? You know, I think it's so important we're talking about energy again, because energy is everything. Because that's what who we are at our core essence. Yes. We are this energy vibration being, you know. And so I find that whatever we're eating and we're drinking, I bless it. I bless it with good energy.
Yes.
And you don't have to do some really weird ritual. You just say thank you, or you just say, you know, this food, this water is full of God's love and blessings, and it's blessing my body and mind and spirit, you know?
Yes.
So you just bless it. So whatever intention and thought you give it, instantly hojinda.
Definitely.
So that is very powerful thing to do.
It is. There are a few people that before eating umatha dekhdiya, right? That is such a nice thing. Shukrana kardiya, and I'm very grateful for this food. And again, when you're cooking it, honjida gurdwara prasad panda langar panda. ਜਿਹਦਾ ਮਾੜਾ ਦਾ ਨਾਲ ਹੈ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਉਹ ਚੀਜ਼ ਹਮੇਸ਼ਾ ਹੀ ਸੋਹਣੀ ਬਣਦੀ ਅਤੇ ਸਾਰੇ ਖੁਸ਼ ਹੋ ਕੇ ਆਨੰਦ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਖਾ ਕੇ ਸਹੀ ਮਾ ਹੈ ਆਪਾਂ ਖੁਸ਼ ਹੋ ਕੇ ਬਣਾਈਏ ਫੈਮਿਲੀ ਲਈ ਖਾਣਾ ਐਂਡ ਦੈਟ ਗਿਵਸ ਦਮ ਗੁੱਡ ਐਨਰਜੀ ਰਾਈਟ ਐਂਡ ਆਲਸੋ ਜੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਕੁਛ ਖਾਣ ਲੱਗਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਤਾਂ ਇਸ ਕੁਆਇਟ ਫਨੀ ਹੋਣਾ ਐਕਚੁਲੀ ਜਦੋਂ ਆਪਾਂ ਕੁਛ ਖਾਣ ਲੱਗਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਜਿੱਦਾਂ ਮਠਿਆਈ ਹੋਵੇ ਕੇਕ ਹੋਵੇ ਤਾਂ ਆਪਾਂ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਇਹਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਤਾਂ ਮੈਂ ਮੋਟੀ ਹੋਣਾ ਖਾ ਕੇ ਮੇਰਾ ਭਾਰ ਵਧਣਾ ਆ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਹੀ ਆਪਾਂ ਕਹਿ ਦਿੱਤਾ
ਇੱਦਾਂ
ਉਹ ਹੋਣਾ ਹੀ ਹੋਣਾ ਅਤੇ ਜੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਗੁਰਦੁਆਰੇ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਖਾ ਲਓ ਪ੍ਰਸ਼ਾਦ ਇਹ ਤਾਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਚੰਗਾ ਆ ਖਾਵੋ ਐਂਡ ਆਪਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਪਤਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਗੁੱਡ ਇੰਟੈਂਸ਼ਨ ਨਾਲ ਅਸੀਂ ਖਾ ਰਹੇ ਹਾਂ ਅਤੇ ਸਾਡੇ ਰਿਜ਼ਲਟ ਵੀ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੀ ਹੋਣਾ ਆ
ਠੀਕ ਹੀ ਹੋਣਾ ਦੈਟਸ ਰਾਈਟ ਹਾਂਜੀ
ਯੂ ਨੋ ਇਟਸ ਅ ਬਿਗ ਵਨ ਫੂਡ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਪਿਕ ਕੀਤਾ ਵੈਰੀ ਵੈਲ ਡਨ ਬਿਕਾਜ਼ ਇਟਸ ਸੋ ਇੰਪੋਰਟੈਂਟ ਐਂਡ ਵੀ ਆਫਨ ਫੋਰਗੇਟ
No, yeah. food is very important, and it really jitta hun tusi banande vi apne roti hai na kitchen de vich us time na make sure tusi ਪਿਆਰ ਨਾ ਬਣਾਓ ਕੋਈ ਪਿਛਲੀਆਂ ਗੱਲਾਂ ਨਾ ਸੋਚੋ ਆਹ ਹੋਇਆ ਇਹ ਹੋਇਆ ਉਹਨੇ ਪਤਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਕੀਤਾ ਉਹੀ ਥਰਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਗੁੱਸਾ ਕ੍ਰੋਧ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਦੈਟ ਸਾਡੇ ਫੂਡ ਵਿੱਚ ਆਉਂਦਾ ਉਹ ਜੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਖਾਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਸਾਡੇ ਅਸਰ ਪੈਂਦਾ ਸਾਡੇ ਉਹੀ ਸਾਡੀ ਬਿਮਾਰੀਆਂ ਉੱਥੋਂ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੀਆਂ
ਯੈਸ
You know, so we have to make sure that roti time, kuch bhi cup, chai ta cup bhi banane na, although you just think of something nice and just say, you know, I love you, thank you. Bas, simple as that.
Makes a big difference, yes. Really. And gaon fir thode bachche dekhoge thonu idda karde, they will pick up these good habits, right? And these are habits for life.
Hanji. And you should start, you know, bachche as soon as they're born, they see that, you know, how important, you know, respecting food, because everything's energy.
Yes.
You respect your food, respect everything, and your life becomes a really beautiful, and your health is wealth. Once you're feeling healthy, everything is just works beautifully around you.
Yeah, you know? And you know, you are what you eat, and so, ਆਪਾਂ ਆਏ ਵੀ ਇੱਥੇ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਪੇਰੈਂਟਸ ਆਏ ਵੀ ਰੋਟੀ ਲਈ ਸੀਗੇ ਸੋ ਵੀ ਕੈਨ ਹੈਵ ਅ ਬੈਟਰ ਕੁਆਲਿਟੀ ਆਫ ਲਾਈਫ ਬੈਟਰ ਫੂਡ ਐਵਰੀਥਿੰਗ ਬੈਟਰ ਦੈਟਸ ਵਾਟ ਵੀ ਕਮ ਫਾਰ ਸੋ ਵੀ ਨੈਵਰ ਸ਼ੁੱਡ ਫੋਰਗੇਟ the root and the core of why hana
so we did an experiment last week as pichle dos milia se I told you about this experiment ek doctor nikita se ka doctor moto that do glass pani de se gaye
oh yes
ek pani de glass te unne likha se ka love and peace and dooje pani de glass label likha se hate and all these horrible anger negative words anger and bitterness and jealousy and so did a che glass the happy one loving one or he used to talk to it in a loving happy I love you this and those said he used to feel the gussa and then I think then about he did under a microscope he checked the little particles of the water and the loving one it looked like little crystal like snowflakes hana and jera the one with the full of gussa and growth and jealousy that looked like dark gunji you know
cloudy
thing hana it just telling you that sada sharir body is mostly 70% water so you imagine aapne apnu koi negative gal keh rahe ho kisi nu keh rahe ha instantly sada pani sharir da pani ke you know ohi sada nuksan hunda sade oh bimari ban jindi ha so saying something loving or sade ohi pani looks like snowflakes crystal saying something terrible or he said under la shri the pani will look like ganji black you know muck
if you speak to yourself with love and care and attention then you feel good anyway mentally physically everything feels good
hold hega ki you've only got yourself and you know the real home is inside and like they say start from the inside out you know how you're feeling on the inside it reflects on the outside it's like for me personally when I get stressed or get tensions I start to get a rash So that just shows me, my body is telling me something's not right.
Yeah.
And you've got to pick up on these little things, right? If we don't,
it's going to get worse.
And it all starts from the inside. And
some people will get like headaches or stomach aches. You know, the hair starts falling out. Yeah. All of the symptoms are there, but we're just not noticing them.
This is it.
We're looking for
them. We're refusing to notice them because our body is like whispering to us. Asi pickni karde, phir jadon jyada hunda the body screaming at you. Phir asi pick karde, phir asi natde, but often it's too late.
Our body, so it's like a divine intelligence.
Yeah.
It's always communicating us through our symptoms.
That's why they say sara kuch ta sade kol aa. Asi bahar dekhde aa, mainu miluga, mainu milugi, main khush hounga. But you have it all, and jere idan tefarde, they're so gone so far from themselves, haven't they?
Yeah.
We've all been there, we've done it. But really, sara kuch thode kol aa, and it's that peace of mind again, manjita jagjita. All the way to conquer the mind, conquer the world.
Andi.
We have it all. Sade Guruji na sanu kinna ko sikhalia. And like you say, nitnem. It's a big one, isn't it? Roj karo, nitnem.
Repetition, practice, kari jao. Bar bar, new lifestyle or new thinking, kari jao, becomes automatic for us. You know, so we listen. It is very important. Listen and pay attention to any body signs and symptoms, because there's a dialogue, there's a communication, a higher consciousness is trying to give us a message. And either we're not eating right, we're not saying, you know, we're not having a nice, healthy dialogue in ourselves about us or other people. So change that, and watch the body symptoms will subside.
Yes. And if something isn't suiting you, or somebody isn't right for you at the moment, this moment in time, you know, you have to draw boundaries, don't you? Because life gives you what it gives you. But it's up to you to set the boundaries.
Yeah.
If you touch a little bit on boundaries, again, it's important, because people, we often forget about the boundaries and we let them go. So, go on.
I just think sometimes, you know, we know the people within our circles who are hurting us or upsetting us in whichever way. And sometimes you have to consciously create a distance, whether that is not answering the phone all the time whenever they call you, or not consciously going to see them, and just kind of withdraw a little bit and wish them well. Hope for, you know, for them to go on their journey in their way, and for you to continue being the way that you are, so that, you know, you don't kind of take on their negativity, because that's going to affect you, and you're going to be left holding on to whatever their issues are. And you may not have those issues, but unfortunately, you know, we're all a bit like sponges, and we will at some level take them on.
And like you said, bless them, let them go, rather than be angry and carry them, and carry that baggage. Odi vich ta ota agla chale gaya thon upset karke jo karna si, they're gone, they've done their part. Hum tusi carry karunge ta thale dukhya, because you know it's gonna keep coming back, because you're carrying it. So you just gotta let it go and just keep yourself at peace. You know, like, you can do things like to change the energy of your room. You can light a candle, you can put a lamp on, you can put agarbatti on, you can do lots. Whatever keeps you at that peaceful place. This is what we hope to give you guys, you know, our experiences, what's happened to us, and just share it with you so we can make a difference to our viewers.
Yeah, and Sadhguru, like I said, it's our responsibility. I don't wait for someone else to make the changes around the house or in my lifestyle. It's my responsibility. You know, like, if certain things in my house don't give me that peace of mind, or certain people in my life that I feel like are not honoring me, I just peacefully just back off and let them just continue with their life. But I don't do it in the sense of I'm better than them. It's not to do with that. It's just that where they are, it's fine, and where I need to be is okay, and it's all right. But some people might feel like, oh my God, I can't walk away certain people in our family, people, because we live in this, you know, family environment where we need to live together, and I can't separate from them. So that's where you will find that you still got to be courageous and strong enough to not let them get you too much. Find something you can distract yourself with, like do some things, start a new hobby or something, leave the house and go somewhere, you know, and don't have to be in each other's face. So this is by respecting your boundaries.
Exactly. Yeah. And the power of words is a big one as well, isn't it?
Oh, definitely.
Like, you know, your tongue can create and it can destroy.
Absolutely.
Whether you're talking to yourself or whether you're talking to somebody else.
Yeah.
So
mental diet is crucial, you know. Whatever we're thinking and talking about here will eventually will conform in the outer world, and we will experience it and thinking, and then you say, "Na mila kyo hoya?" Because you're thinking about it, that dialogue eventually will manifest and, you know, be a tangible thing out there.
Yes.
So it's very important to see apne apne, because we're constantly talking to ourselves.
We are.
And
that's,
we don't realize,
kind of, that goes on. Yeah.
It never stops. But we don't realize most of that, 90% of that talk is not very, you know, honoring ourselves. It's mostly about self-sabotaging and disempowering ourselves.
Cover a little bit on the conscious and the subconscious.
Yeah. So the subconscious mind is like it's 95% of our life, you know, playing out all the time, every moment. And 5% is just our conscious mind, which is our creative and thinking part. So conscious mind, I might say, oh, I'm going to eat healthy today. I, you know, decided now I'm healthy, and I'm going to be careful. I'm going to bless my food. You know, it sounds good and it sounds sensible thing to do. Why not do it? But if that's 5%, but if my subconscious mind believes in, I don't value myself, I don't think I'm good enough, I don't think I'm, you know, I'm healthy, you know,
there's
enough.
Resistance there,
there's resistance there. It's just playing on a subconscious level that we picked up from a young child. That's usually where the subconscious programs, our patterns, our behaviors start from, the first 7 years of our life. If that's playing, so all of a sudden I'll forget that, because it would override my conscious 5%. 5% my carries, you know? I'm going to bless my food, I'm going to be careful what I eat. But as soon as I start thinking about the past or the future, the subconscious mind will kick in, my program of, like, I'm not good enough, you know, I'm not special enough. Yeah.
Like,
so
that,
all of a sudden, I'm not good enough, so I don't... That will play out. All of a sudden, I won't bless my food because I believe I'm not good enough, so I'm not good enough to bless my food. Can you see?
Definitely. And Jidda Bairaj Galagadiyasi, on the way here, we're talking about, you know how everybody always says, go back to the child, the inner child in you, when you were 7 years old, what was you feeling?
Yeah.
A lot of people don't understand that, is
it? I know. They find that quite difficult because they think, like you were saying, I had a very good, you know.
When I was seven, I was in a really good place. All I have is, like, really good, happy memories.
Yeah. And that's all I mostly, consciously, we remember happy, good memories because we are designed to survive on this planet as a human species. So I, as a little child, as a young, very young child, we would only remember the good memories because that's how we're going to function through our life. You know, but the traumatic memories, the sad memories, we bury them deep in our subconscious mind because keep remembering them as a child, we're not going to survive. We're not going to live with all the pressure of that traumatic memory. So we bury it. But that is becomes a subconscious behavior that's playing out in 95% of our life.
Yes.
And we're not aware of it. So like an experience you were saying, like if I felt my family, my parents did not give me, they were very controlling and they did not give
strict.
Me respect.
They were strict. They were always waiting for us.
Yeah.
You have that, don't you? You remember that. And from there comes that control thing.
Yeah. And there's lot of feelings of feeling sad and alone and abandoned, rejected, and it's hard to deal as a young child, so we bury that memory in a subconscious life memory, but that is what plays out rest of your life.
You know, it's such fascinating stuff, but jinna chera pa apne aap te kam nahi kita hai, had the work done, had the healing or had this coaching to really understand all this, you don't realize, but it's really fascinating once you get into it, and you that's when you really get to know who you are, and you're in so alignment with yourself.
So that's why we say to him, but I feel I'm a very good person. I do love myself. I love my family. I go out of my way. I take care of the house. I do all the dinner. But then why do I feel that they don't treat me with love and respect? They ignore me. They don't understand me. But that's because the subconscious mind, our program is playing out.
Yeah.
So that's always there all the time, and we become aware of it because we have so many incidents that happen, the same theme playing out through all our life, and then you think, oh my god, why is this happening again? Fear ho gaya. And that's when you think, ah, where's this actually the root cause
coming from?
And when we go back to the root cause and actually change that meaning behind it and actually say, no, maybe the parents did not give me the attention, but I'm going to learn to give myself her attention. I'm going to be there to support me.
Yes.
Yeah. And that's where this transformation happens. Mm-hmm. And then once you start changing the energy and frequency around there, because every thought has an energy and frequency, the more you start, like you're saying, repeating nitnam, japping that I value myself, I respect, I understand myself, and you make that more and more and more, and becomes eventually that becomes a subconscious new belief, and that same world, same dunya, all of a sudden becomes a very understanding, a loving,
kind and caring
world.
Those repeated patterns change, don't they? And then you get the good patterns repeating.
Yeah. So the wording, actually, we didn't have to change that. We changed our beliefs.
Yes.
And then we saw the world through a different lens.
Yes.
Mm. And all of a sudden, the world became very easy and harmonious and comforting and kind and gentle.
It's like when we have a chat, we always say, you know, I really like my life because I understand me and it's very much in alignment.
Yeah.
And I do, you know, as much as I want or as little as I want, because we're aligned with ourselves, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Otherwise, we could go around, you know, run rugged and evikaliya, and keep putting yourself last, which is what our mums used to do, right?
Yeah.
You know, they used to put everybody and everything before them, that apne apno piche.
Yeah.
And they never had time for themselves, right?
Yeah.
They never spent that much money on themselves because they wanted to make sure we had everything.
Mm. That's right.
And I think this is where we have made the changes, because we understand the importance of you.
Yes. Yeah.
And it all starts with you. And if you're okay, you're happy with yourself, the rest of the family, the rest of the house will be okay.
Mm. And that's how we grew up, haven't we? Yeah. Even our parents and everyone. It's to say, like, everybody else is important. You make sure you go out and you fulfill their needs.
Mm. Yes.
And then you be accepted by them. You be liked and loved by them even more.
So you're fitting into somebody else's idea of who you should be.
Yeah.
And it's that word should, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's so powerful.
Yeah.
And we don't realise that. We should, you know, dress nicely. We should always have our hair combed and, you know, not speak out of disrespect to our elders. And all these things make you feel less worthy of who you are.
Yeah,
that's right.
Even in EastEnders, they've covered that, haven't they? Loki Gilge.
Yeah.
That's a big one for us. And that's why we are people pleasers and we're always the good girl. And we often don't even live our life on our terms because we, you know, cheat on ourselves, don't we?
Yeah.
And our life's passing you by and we keep putting everything off.
Yeah.
And we think, galung, that post that I put up, it was like, so resonates, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Because it's true, isn't it? And that fear just doesn't come.
Asi aapne humne abandon mission kar de rahe, neglect asi aapne humne reject kar de rahe. But then somebody else does it, who is sanu saru reject saru abandon us, we get so hurt. We get so offended, thinking, why did they do that? You know, I'm always being there for them.
Yeah.
But how often are we there for us? We abandon our needs.
Mm-hmm.
But then when somebody abandons our needs, that's when we think that the world is such a horrible place.
We get frustrated when people don't meet our expectations.
Yes.
Yeah.
And whereas if we didn't have those expectations and did what made us feel happy, or you as an individual, it would be easier to accept that people are always going to let you down, and it's okay for them to let you down, and because you're always going to let people down, not consciously, but life happens.
Yeah, because we don't know what the other person's expecting of us, and sometimes it's okay, like, not to know what they're expecting of you, because you just be you.
But the beautiful thing is, right, when you are really sort of honoring yourself and you're not letting yourself down, and then you are feeling confident and you're loving your imperfections and they're okay, and if somebody out there is letting you down, because you're not letting yourself down, but somebody out there is letting you down, you don't notice it.
No.
Because your lens have changed.
Yes.
You turn it this down here. It could be happening, but you won't even be aware of it.
Because you're so content with who you are, and you're happy in your world.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
That's right.
And you don't even notice. Like, say, never mind, it doesn't matter.
What is the relationship we have with ourselves? If we feel that we're judging ourselves, we will see outside people
yes.
judge being judgmental. Yes. If we are loving and honoring ourselves, then ohi baad isna, people honoring and loving yes. themselves and loving us, and we're loving them. So it's easy as that.
And I think if someone does let you down and you're content, which is what you've just
yeah,
said,
yeah.
you're not bothered. You're
no, like, no, no.
Because you've already got a backup plan.
Yeah.
And you're already thinking, well, if this doesn't work out, I can go and do this, I can do that, I can go and have a bath, watch a movie, or whatever it is.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you don't put the whole of your expectation
no.
in that person.
No.
So therefore you kind of... You are honouring yourself, and that's the beautiful
yeah.
thing about
you. And you're taking action to be
yeah.
you, who you're supposed to be here,
yeah.
right? And what your life purpose is.
Yeah.
And, you know, we were saying this, and how many our age ladies get a chance to do this? So
yeah.
we're really grateful,
yes.
you know,
definitely.
To Kanchi TV for giving
yeah.
us this platform to be able to make a difference. And also to bring other guests on and give them a voice.
Yes.
And to
yeah.
be able to talk about what they have to talk about.
Mm.
Because... our mums didn't get this.
Yeah.
No,
so
yeah.
this is where we have
and
stood up and made that
difference. And I feel that we are a voice for our ancestors.
Our mothers.
Yeah, our
yeah,
mothers
we are.
And their mothers.
We are because
yeah.
they gave us so much
yeah.
and now it's time to really make a difference for what they were thinking, what
yeah.
they couldn't change
yeah.
and we can change.
Yeah. They were busy nurturing everybody else
they were.
And
yeah.
they actually now realise it's important to nurture ourselves
yes.
before we can nurture anybody else.
Yeah.
And this is the platform that we can allow to
you know, one, may I have something else? It's really funny actually. When I was going to get married, the microwaves had just come out
yeah.
1984 and my dad said microwave like a dinner. My mom for the first time put her foot down, she said nay many like a dinner because I don't go ni haga. I thought
yeah.
well done mom
yeah.
because she said nay, she goes melan apela menu like a day. So she got one and then she got me one.
So you didn't get the jugs and the six glasses.
Oh, lots of them, they were like big things. See how things have changed,
yeah,
like we say when we
much.
Talk about weddings and things and
yeah.
we laugh because
yeah.
everybody used to bring a present with
yeah.
like a jug and six glasses
yeah, yeah.
or a donga and six kolinga. And we had so many.
Those for dessert.
Yes.
And those were so that.
But
so the whole purpose
honom
of them
honom
was, no, but the whole purpose of them was that you remember to give all your guests something to drink.
Yes,
and
yes.
after you've made them dinner,
yes.
you give them dessert.
Give them
yeah.
dessert.
There was a
yeah.
whole thought
there
process
was.
That went behind all
there
that.
Was.
Yeah.
You put
yeah.
on there, pela pani
yeah.
da glasa or juice, and then make sure you give them dessert.
Yeah.
And then there were the dinner sets.
Yeah.
But you know, now those things, we look for them in the
yeah.
shops and we can't even find them.
I'll get you some.
Yeah, get me some. But you know, it's like, it's
people
good
be
to
sending
talk.
Them into the studio.
There will be. It's good to talk about these things because
yeah.
we often forget what our elders did and what
yeah.
they sacrificed.
Yeah.
But I think that's where a lot of mental health came from, though.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know, where our parents were, didn't feel like they had a voice in any situation.
Yeah.
Mm. They were frustrated. They were angry. They were pleasing so many people, and they couldn't actually work out what was going on
but
with their own bodies.
But they that program from their parents and their
yeah.
parents.
Yeah.
It's been
and
going
where,
on. But
this
they weren't
is the
living,
change, isn't it?
But nobody was really living authentically because
no.
all we're living out the programs that we've learned from the
yeah.
environment around
yes.
us. That's
yeah.
where the programs come
yes.
from the first
yes.
7 years. So it's crazy, isn't it, if you think about it, that we're not living from our thinking and our decisions. We're automatically, subconsciously making decisions from what we learned
yeah.
from everybody around us.
And I think that's really, really, and also it's really, really hard to undo that. It's not something that will just happen. It's
yeah,
you
but
know,
that's
if,
where
if you're living
the repetition
in a family,
comes in.
If you're living in a family where there's expectations from your mother-in-law, your husband, your children, and your grandparents, or it's very hard to be your own person.
Yeah, yeah.
And,
it is
and
very
we're
hard.
We're in a position
yeah.
where, you know, we're speaking from a
yeah.
position of being in that space.
Yeah.
And for other people who aren't there or would like to be there, we've got to think about that side
yeah.
of, and how that's working out.
And
for
our
them.
Parents' generation, everybody did live in extended families,
yeah.
so they didn't really have, you know, that much power to
yeah.
just do their own thing.
Yeah.
Because
and I think everybody had a specific role.
They did.
You were the cook, or
yeah.
you were the person that went out to work. Or, do you know what I mean? Whereas
yeah.
now, women don't want that. They want to be
yeah.
able to do everything.
Yeah. And also, we do make our life easier because they used to make sure everything was done from home. Safai bhi aapke karne, kapde lere bhi aapke karne, purane ane entertain aapke karna. We actually think, okay, I'll get a cleaner, it's okay. Or I'll get the food from outside.
Yeah, yeah.
We kind of compromise
so
and we
now.
Make our life easier.
Yeah.
Whereas, you know, honestly, you look back and you think, and in extended families, so there were two families and say there were 8-9 children, you know, it's hard,
yeah,
isn't
yeah.
it? Then the cleaning,
and
then the feeding.
And they used to the sink in the kitchen.
Yeah, and feeding everybody.
Yeah.
So they did have it hard. I know we've got to work, So that's why we, because we work, we have the luxuries we have today, right? And we are where we are. We can invest in ourselves. We can invest in getting a life coach, because coaches, albeit they have to spend money as well with other coaches to get themselves better. And we are growing all the time. And I think we've let go of main sahi ha, jo main kehndi ha, oh sahi ha. Because je tusi hamesha sahi ha, you're not even growing. Tusi ko sikhya hi nahi hai ga. Because you're just focused on just being right all the time.
It's your ego.
It's your ego. And to be growing and to be evolving, you've got to be doing the work.
And we got no choice sometimes, because when we think that we know it all, because you don't know, you know, and hoi janda, like you were saying, that it's hard to break free from these programs that we sort of like acquired from a young age. But when time and when our soul's ready to break free from this program, something traumatic will happen. Like you went through your, you know, really traumatic time. We've all gone through some major, major crisis. And that you said, that's where that crisis is a blessing in disguise, because that is actually there to help us break free from those programs that we acquired from our parents and their parents and their parents. So we're breaking free and helping them to break free. Because when, like I said, that post, when one woman heals, we're healing our children, our mothers, and everyone.
Yeah, absolutely.
So that's when we have an opportunity, because like you said, they're so hard to break these programs.
Definitely.
But when we have something major, all of a sudden we find our lives completely fallen apart. We're like in pieces and everything, but there's a blessing in there because we have to rebuild ourselves from the new pieces.
Pieces
can have new programs.
Yes.
And it's going to have new way of thinking and seeing the world through a new lens.
Yes, and all jadon hunda we don't see anything, but apart from that, so, you know, everything's shattered, it's all broken, but if you have faith and slowly you will get there. And that's where the inspiration comes from, because I always say, if I could do it, anybody can do it. And it's just having your faith and then accepting, like we said at the beginning, because, you know, hukum ya, isn't it? Whatever happens is hukum. But, you know, you've still got to do the work, because life the bitch goshna, ups and downs, the honor. And if you have done the work, if I had known what I know today, I probably wouldn't have suffered so much. I suffered a lot because minu pata ni siga, and I was, you get disconnected from who you are. And I was disconnected for years, and then once I had that rebirth, it really shook me.
So you were going not just to the grieving of you and your beloved husband, but also grieving, you don't realize on a subconscious, you're grieving the programs you've been carrying. They become part of your identity.
Absolutely.
So you, that's the suffering continued for a while, because a new version, like you're going to a new, like a rebirth. So,
because the programs are running where, oh my God, I don't like the white colours, right? What people expecting me to wear? Figurang, no makeup. Are people expecting me to ask them about any decision that I make? Are my finances going to be controlled? All these programs are running in your head, and I have to be good. I have to listen to everybody, because that's what everybody's telling
expecting
of me. And obviously, then you have a massive expectation of yourself.
So the suffering was coming from this, you're in a conflict, because your old program is still trying to stay attached to you, but also your life is falling apart because a new version has to be rebirthed. There's a rebirth happening, and you're going through that canal, you know, but that's the most tough part. But like you said, there is light at the end of the tunnel.
There is, and I love the new version of me. So sad what I had to go through to get here, but the old me was a feisty, angry, my way or no way jazz. But you know, the new jazz, even I really like myself, and it's a big one to say, I really love myself and I really like the way I am and the way I handle situations and the way I live my life on my terms. And if I can make a difference to one other woman or one other person out there, my mission is accomplished, right? And God has sent amazing people to actually help me on this journey. Look at you two, you know, we give our time because we want to give it, it's our seva, it's about making a difference. And again, that comes from our Guruji's teachings, seva karo, hana? And if we can, the experience that I've had, if I didn't share it with anybody, took it with me to my grave, What a waste! Because if you share it with someone else, it can be helpful for someone else, and that actually helps you as well. Mm-hmm. And when you talk about stuff, I've said this so many times, you create a movement, and mm-hmm. the other person thinks, yeah, she's speaking about it, mm-hmm. and it's safe because I wanted to hear that. Mm-hmm. So I actually want to share a bit.
Yeah.
And that's what we're trying to do with these chat shows, is to make a difference and to talk about anything. And I often feel sorry for the men out there. Yeah. It's International Men's Day tomorrow.
Okay.
So I just want to say, you know, all the best to you, all you men out there who are watching this, brothers, fathers, husbands, sons, because at the end of the day, you need to talk about whatever's bugging you as well. And I always feel so happy when I'm coming to this chat show, when I'm going to my Yul Saheli events, we're going to get together, we're going to talk about stuff that you wouldn't often talk with family members, right?
Yeah.
But when you're with like-minded people,
yeah.
it's amazing what happens, right? That's where the magic happens. Yes,
absolutely.
And you feel so at home,
yes,
like we guys do today. So it's nearly time to end the show. So my final message to you all is, don't forget to do your bit of the recycling and just do your bit for the planet. And also look after yourself and look after your mental health always, yeah? Little things, a walk in the nature. And good deal.
And if there are any men out there, you know, especially with it being Men's Day tomorrow,
International Day
tomorrow, that this program, you know, although we do talk about a lot of women kind of stuff, but it equally affects men, and, you know, hope that you'll find something from this for yourselves as well.
Yeah, and what we just said earlier on, everything's energy, we're energy. We look like bodies, but actually we're energy and we're vibrating frequency. Did that see sort there? That becomes our reality. So bless your food, bless yourself, and bless everyone. And your life will be a very happy life. Thank you.
And God bless, and hope to see you all very soon. Jai Gurudev.
Jai Gurudev.
Thank you.